Hello and good evening, everyone. I was just looking. Looks like we had an update recently. Little small update. Alright, so we're picking up Jedi Knight storyline where we left off last week. Last week we wrapped up the planet Balmora. And so, timeline-wise, one thing that takes place in between Balmora and going to Quesh, which is the next class objective, one thing that occurs in between is two flashpoint stories. So the first thing I'm going to do is going to run Taral or Taral 5 and then boarding party. Alright, from Colonel Finley, Madel. Good call on taking that Imperial spy on Balmora into Republic custody. Madel's been very helpful in providing information about the Empire and their activities in the area. Guess she wants to stay in our good books so we don't turn her over to the Resistance. Smart girl. Thanks to her info, we intercepted an Imperial shipment heading off-world. Found some stuff you might be interested in. Figured it's only fair since you sent her our way, Colonel Finley. And here's an enhancement. Thank you, Colonel Finley. Appreciate that. Let's see if I can use that anywhere. Got an 80. Not many of these things I don't think have enhancements. They're all static pieces, I think. Yep. Well, this one, but wrist pieces don't have enhancements. That's got a 96. So better. And, yep. Do have one there. No enhancement on this one. Alright, so there's one that's useful. Okay, cool. Alright, so that's the plan, is to go ahead and do those. And since I'm going to go that direction, I'm actually going to go to a practical step. And I'm going to check. I don't think this thing has that set up, but no. Okay. I'm going to go to a practical step and get some just like the weekly bonus for Group Finder. So it makes no sense for me to be to Odessa except that it's easier to use the facilities there, so. Storyline wise, this makes no sense at all. I'm just taking a practical step. Okay, so we get the bonus credit for that now. Okay, so we're looking specifically, we're going to filter the two we're looking for, Taral 5 and... I don't have boarding party, that's interesting. Oh, is that a solo one now? Oh no, Taral 5 is a story one available. I don't have boarding party. Am I looking in the wrong place? Hold on, let me look at the chart that I was using. Oh, I'm sorry, boarding party was the other side. Sorry. Maelstrom Prison, that was the other one. Actually, both of these are available story versions, so we're going to do those. We will save this for another day. And... Yeah, let's just use this to go over to story, and we'll be able to do the full story for it. So, let's head over there. So let's just go over this real quick, because the way this way of doing it kind of skips the intro with OTEG. Let's see. Jedi Master named OTEG recruited you for a top secret mission. Enter the Empire's impregnable Maelstrom Prison and free a captive Jedi with vital information on the enemy's plans. First, you must find a way to navigate the Maelstrom Nebula. A Grease supercomputer at the Empire's Fortress on Taral 5 can make the necessary calculations, but you'll still have to steal it. Flat capture an Imperial shuttle to Taral 5 to begin the flashpoint. So, that's why these two are connected. Because first you steal the shuttle, and then you use it to fly through the Maelstrom Nebula to the prison. And is this the same stuff? Yep, okay. So the cool news is, since they have this available in story mode, we can just do that. We don't have to worry about teaming up with other people who want a spaceport for everything. That voice, of course, was OTEG, and we're totally pulling Kira with us.
Ready for anything.
Are you? Well, okay then. Anything it shall be then. Taral V looks strangely like Drummond Kos. The textures look the same, the rocks, the grass. It all looks the same to me. It's almost like it should have been Drummond Kos, but wasn't. Creatures look similar. Not quite exactly the same, I guess. Let's see. A bonus for getting jungle creatures. That seems reasonable. Oh, level 50, cool. You know, back when I started playing the game, that was the major milestone. Brings back fond memories. Let's see, is there a clicky over here? I see some blue glowy stuff. Bada boomski. There you go. Why are you running around with your sabers up in the air, girl? What's up? Oh yeah, we get creatures from the deep come play with us. That's fun. Nobody asked you to come play. Hey, thanks, appreciate it. It's not the big accomplishment it used to be, but it's still pretty cool. Well, you guys gotta be setting stuff on fire, man. What a mess. Hello, what was that? Well, who asked you to show up and rain on the parade? What's this thing over here? Oh, a crash shuttle. Oh. Bonus. Okay. Jungle Beast. Mere Jungle Beast. So you're on the inside right now? Ooh, a toughie. Hey Jinx, got a question for you. Is the stream looking choppy? So I'm starting to get feedback from OBS that it's dropping frames to Twitch. Everything looks good to me, but I'm playing on the computer. I'm not looking at the output, so. This might be back to TPS. Oh, shoot. Okay. Okay, interesting. Yeah, this is, for me, everything looks very smooth, but OBS is saying that it's dropping, it's going up, hitting about 10% of the frames, which is, well, 3 per second, so. Well, on the plus side, if these flashpoints I do today end up not looking very good, it's okay, because you can always run them again. You can only run the story stuff when you're on that piece of the story, but flashpoints you can do anytime. An improvement. I don't get many gear improvements. That's good. Oh yes, because my biggest problem so far is all your chattering. This guy, or this guy, somewhat. Ah. Hello, Sentinel droid. Who's in here? Just more people to dice up. About to break my record. Not happening, Kira. Not happening. Interesting. Oh, okay, it's a pull through. Research station. Bye-bye, research station. Put those things away, honey. Before you cut your hair off. Hello. How are you doing? Little Star Wars. What are you doing?
Not much.
Not much?
I'm applying lotion to my skin.
That's good. How's that going?
Well, it's starting to dry up.
Okay.
Which is good because I applied a lot.
I see.
At least it smells good.
Mm-hmm. It sure does. Smells fantastic.
I think I might take my medicine a bit later today because my hands are really slippery and I don't wanna drop anything. And at the same time, I don't want my lotion to get on my medicine.
Okay.
To affect the taste.
It's probably a good idea. Nobody wants to eat that. somebody. Not you. Well, they hit me with all they had. Alright, I think we got a thing here. Surprise!
The time for subtlety is almost over. Make your way carefully to the fortress once you arrive. Strike quickly and hard.
Hey Google, turn off alert office lights.
There's no pleasant way to make a frontal assault on an Imperial fortress.
No.
Normally I'd advise you to minimize casualties, but our objective is to avoid. No problem carrying it out. I'll keep quiet from here on, unless it's an emergency. Okay, Doc.
What a mess, huh? What a mess. Nope, okay. Oh well. Let's see, this was the big blue shield a second ago. So it's now cleared away. Do, okay, cool. Oh well. Let's see. Looking for the bonus, we're looking for research stations and security terminals, so keep looking for those, but we're maxed out on the jungle things and all that kind of stuff, so. Well, I mean, if they insist. Looks like we have to use the bridge. And those guys are too far away to leap to. Okay. That's too bad. Feel my force. I think it's the optional objective things that are in here. Yeah, there's a thermal slice and other things like that, so no reason not to do the bonuses. Might as well. There's one over here. I don't even know where any of these are really, because groups never do these bonuses. So I'm just kind of guessing. Hope I haven't missed too many of them. I should go back to the barracks and see if there's anything there. I'm not sure. See, that's continuing on. What's back over here? Oh, just more of you guys. Oh, it looks like there'd be a back door back here or something. No, maybe not. Hello, Cortana? What the heck do you want? Nobody's talking to you. This is just another exit. There was a back door. Dagnabbit. I just didn't want to attack those things, so I didn't go. I knew it. Dang it. Oh well. Alright, yeah, so there were a few in there, so. Let's see. There's not a thing over there, so. Skip that. Hello. How are you? That's me. I'm here. Nope.
Yes.
Not a thing. Huh, so close. So close. Oh well. Let's see, anything over here? Looks like a big nothing, I guess. It's an unlabeled building. What could an unlabeled building be? Nothing important. No doors. Let's see. Looks like these guys have a little terminal at the end, too. Oh, wait. There isn't even a thing down here. Oh, man. Dang. Oh well. Let's see. Need a few more security terminals. A few more research stations. Alright, making progress. Doctor somebody or another. It looks important. Excuse me while I slice into your station. Don't pay any attention to me, though. I'm not really here. You just don't see me. Oh, where'd that guy go? There he is. Almost. Security terminal. Looks like there'd be more research stations up here. Maybe there's some upstairs or something. Well, there's something up here. Let's see. There's room to be here for something. No clicky in here. There's the clicky. Alright, well, that's one of them. One more. One more of each. One more of each. Hopefully I didn't just miss them. Let's see what we've got left in here. I guess that's about it for this facility. I got Dr. What's-His-Face. Very useful for me, but you know, hey, that's okay. Right, Didn't I come in that way? I did come in that way. Research station, one more security terminal. Gotta be right here somewhere. Maybe in one of these rooms. There's a research station right over there. Terminal. Two even. You know, just in case. So, let's see what we've got here. Defeat Lord Hasper. Override experimental weapons console. Where's that? Over there. And that? Over there. Okay, cool. We have to go visit the command center, which should be up over here somewhere. Evil will both die in flames. All right, good to know. So, looks like it's that guy over there. Okay. Excuse me, we'll just kind of go this way. And that should be good right there. Lord Hasper. I haven't had too much of a healing issue, so I don't think it's going to be a problem. Mr. Combat Support Droid seems fine. Thank you. some help, girl. What, am I stopping you or something? There's no clicky, right? Okay, we're all good there. How about this? That's not a thing? No, okay. Alright, override security door, override experimental weapons console. Cool, okay. Now over that way. Oh yeah, we gotta get past Robot Man. Well, all right, I guess. Carrot, don't stand in the red stuff. Come on, girl. How's that non-sentient theory working out for you? Still thinking about that? Thinking maybe you need to reevaluate. Who's non-sentient now? You scrap heap. And away we go. Must be a thing. Feels like the security door? Sure.
You are my doorstep.
You?
Always favored me. You've been busy since our last meeting, said Coruscant, Titan. Pity about your freighties, but you can't win them all. Sadly, your victories end here. My fleet is about to bombard your position from orbit. Have been deactivated. You're standing in a tomb. I'm buried in it. It's been a pleasure catching up, but you won't escape this time.
Get me some Greek computer over here. Come on now. That's it? That's where we're going? Okay, let's go that way. Oh, a surface astromech. Well, how convenient for you to be there. Let's see. Repair all. Give me one second here, because we'll probably sell some junk to you, too. Another bitter ear. Wow, 2 and 1 flashpoint. Amazing. Cool. Alright, well, let's vendor dump this junk. Bye-bye. Wait, can we distract the... I don't know how this works. Is that a thing? No, it's not a thing. Okay. I don't really know how that thing works. Alright. We don't need any of this stuff. Bye. Okay. What are our other objectives? I mean, optionals. Just override a weapons console, which must be... Oh, they're both down here in the lab. Okay. It's amazing how killing the last one automatically opens the door. It's like it magically unlocks everything. Hello, scientist. If you don't mind, I'll just allow you to live. Just, stay there and be quiet. Okay. Other objective in this room other than move through it over to there, so I think we can probably just kind of sneak around the edge here. Thank you. don't think the upstairs is actually needed for anything. I don't want to go up there. We'll just keep going straight, right? Maybe. Good luck with that. Don't think it's going to turn out well for you, though. Not sure that's how that works. Oh, that's right. We gotta talk to somebody up here. I forgot. He's not very happy that he smashed into his base and made a mess and blah, 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 blah. Dude, don't get snippy.
To do with that, and the Empire has every right to imprison anyone who threatens its security. When the rest of the galaxy hears of this unprovoked assault, the Republic's evil will finally be exposed. It will surprise no one when the Jedi are revealed as warmongers. All you've ever sought is my culture's extermination.
Save your accusations. Greed technology isn't easy to come by. Where did the Empire find it?
Darth Malgus obtained the computer during an expedition to the Outer Rim. I don't know more than that, and I don't care. You're condemning hundreds of civilian science vessels exploring the Maelstrom Nebula. Electromagnetic radiation alters the safe navigation routes every moment. Without precise and timely coordinates from the Greed computer, thousands of good people, innocent scientists, will be trapped there forever.
The Republic doesn't leave civilians to die. Transmit fresh coordinates to your science vessels and order them home. Then, the computer is ours.
But our research, all that dangerous exploration will have been for nothing without a complete map. Transmitting the coordinates now. The computer is yours. I hope it breaks the first time you use it.
I hope it breaks the first time you use it. Nice. Greed computer, alright. Oh, I missed it. Dang. Alright, well, let's take a look at what that was. Greed computer, it said. There we are. The Greed are one of the galaxy's oldest civilizations, and their initial expansion in ancient times, before they encountered the aggressive and militarily superior Infinite Empire, was aided by their remarkable technology, including sophisticated navigational computers. These computers, operating on principles that are still a mystery to modern technologists, allowed Greed starships to safely traverse turbulent areas of space, including vast asteroid fields and the Maelstrom Nebula. The Republic SIS believes the Greed computer used by the Empire was recovered from an ancient derelict starship and studied on Drummondkos. When its potential was realized, the Empire authorized the Greed computer's release to allow the construction of the Maelstrom prison. It's likely the computer's interface has undergone some modifications. Devices designed for the six-limbed cephalopodian Greed are rarely convenient for humanoids. Seems to make sense. And that does end the flashpoint for Taral V. I believe this is our exit. All right, so we're going to follow that one up and go to the prison. Now, since we're doing that, let me go over here and let's just go ahead and talk. We'll do the whole story thing here. There we go. Let's start story mode. There you go. Bonus. Okay, cool. And so now we got the Maelstrom prison. Now, is it the same thing if you go here? I'm not sure. Oh, okay. Alright, so that's the same thing then. So now that I've stolen the computer and the shuttle with the computer, we're going to use it to get through the nebula, apparently. And all that exciting nebula navigation just sort of happens off screen. Something's pretty cool looking. I assume it's part of the nebula, since this is where the prison is. Stuff everywhere. All right, bonus. Bonus. Defeat Imperial forces. 12 of 100. Well, I suppose it's a prison, so it must be a big prison. Stockpile, I think. Thank you. What? Hey, you over there, just ignore us. We're not really here. It's no problem. You don't see us. Okay, now maybe you see us. Mysterious voice. The very mysterious lady. Ah. Clicky.
Ah.
feel like we've been in this hallway before. Prison archives. What's the prison archives? Is that supposed to be a thing? I guess it may have some. Maybe it has some bonus things in there. I don't know. Two terminals in there. Perfect. Well, that's great. always easier in story mode, but, you know. The old Sith Asylum. See, defeat the unleashed beast 2 of 30. Okay. So there's a bonus for that. Oh, did you suddenly find you have a card available? Thanks, man. Glad you finally discovered that. Legendary Tarantatek is a vicious tusked monster that feeds on the blood of Force sensitives. Of course they do. Tarantateks are known to cluster wherever there is a strong Dartzak presence and to remain dormant for many years before emerging to hunt. How Tarantateks came to be is a subject of much debate. Ancient chronicles report Tarantatek-like creatures on Corbin, twisted by the dark side rituals performed by early Dark Jedi. Other sources attribute their creation directly to the Sith Lord Exar Kun, who performed many force experiments on creatures on Yavin 4. Tarantateks are undoubtedly one of the most vicious of all creatures steeped in the dark side, and they are doubly dangerous because of their unnatural resistance to force powers. Jedi throughout the ages have tried to wipe Tarantateks from the galaxy, but the creatures have proven incredibly resilient. The most recent concerted effort was 3 centuries ago. Many Tarantateks were destroyed, but the hunt took the lives of many Jedi Masters as well. Okay. And there you go. I have a feeling we may see a few more of those guys. What are you doing here? What's this thing? No clicky. Okay. Alright. Oops, so let's go this way. You guys coming or what?
You came all this way just to die. How pathetic. I had a destiny.
Oh, well, sorry about that. Sure who we missed fighting, but okay then. Thank you. credulity.
This embarrassing farce ends here. Securing the Emperor's prisoner is your only priority. Deal with this annoyance another time.
There's no time like the present, my lord. I'll accomplish both objectives.
No matter how good you think you are, it won't be enough.
Jedi, always full of confidence. Until you burn a hole.
Empire salutes you, Grand Moff Killrat. I leave you to reclaim your honor.
Glory to the Empire! My honor will be satisfied.
Seems to be stuck at this percent. Does not seem to be progressing at all. Are we missing something? Are we supposed to click something back here? I don't know. But he's stuck at this percentage and ain't moving. I've heard of this kind of bug happening sometimes. I'm not sure there's much you can do about it. Okay, what else over here?
I don't deserve this.
Oh.
There was so much left to conquer.
Oh, suddenly you die. Okay. Well, great, because I was getting tired of fighting you. Okay. Well, don't know how that worked, but whatever.
Thank you.
the legend.
Serve him as I did centuries ago.
You look good for your age, Revan. What's your secret?
I led my allies to the galaxy's edge to destroy the Emperor. He didn't understand his true power. I lost everyone, betrayed from within. The Emperor imprisoned me, kept me alive with Sith alchemy. Used me.
What use were you to him locked up in here?
I've known both sides of the Force, light and dark. But to him, I was a conduit. The Emperor used me as his link to the light side of the Force, the Jedi Order. Through me, he saw visions. That same link also gave me influence. I convinced the Emperor peace was in his best interest, and tempered his hate.
The peace is lost.
Okay, well there we go. That is the Maelstrom Prison. Ah, level 52. Nice. Let's see. What do we have to say about Revan? An influential figure in both the Mandalorian Wars and the Jedi Civil War, the man known as Revan was Jedi, Sith, and general across his long career. As a charismatic young Jedi Knight, Revan ignored the Jedi Council's orders to remain neutral in the Mandalorian Wars and led many Jedi, including his friend Malak, into battle. While pursuing the remnants of the beaten Mandalorian fleet, Revan encountered the Sith Emperor Andriman Koss and, also alongside Malak, fell to the dark side. Becoming Darth Revan, he led his followers in a war to conquer the Republic and re-establish a Sith order until he was betrayed and nearly killed by Malak. As a result of his injuries, Revan lost his memory and was given a new identity by the Jedi Council. The reborn Revan fought against his old followers, defeating Malak and redeeming himself, but the existence of the true Sith Empire, hidden away in the dark of the galaxy, remained a secret. In the aftermath, as his memory began to return, Revan left the Republic to confront the Sith Emperor, but his plans to destroy the Emperor failed. Revan's allies were killed and Revan himself was imprisoned, kept alive by unnatural means for 300 years. While the Sith Emperor fed on his strength. However, the link between them went both ways, and Revan was able to subtly keep the Emperor in check. Cool. Well, that sounds like a good guy to find for the Jedi Knight storyline, as our goal is to find and eliminate the Emperor. Which is why I thought it would be an important time to come through and collect the story. keep thinking there's a lore object in here, but then I can't find it, so I guess maybe there isn't one. Okay. Alright, well, exit we go. Shoop. Take our stolen shuttle with a greedy computer back to the fleet, I guess. Or something. Maybe we have to take a different one. I guess a different one. Different loading dock. Okay. Well, that's gonna do it for tonight's stream. Thanks to everyone who joined in tonight. Certainly do appreciate you dropping by. Having a good time. Hope you enjoyed the two flashpoints we did. We're able to do them in story mode. Very excited about that. That was a lot of fun. We'll be back tomorrow night with Animal Crossing. And then we'll be back on Thursday with additional Star Wars. Probably doing the some additional level 75 flashpoints, I imagine. Likely for Thursday. So, thanks again for joining. Certainly appreciate it. If you got any questions or comments about the channel, shoot me a message on Twitter at MaxGameMike, and I'd be happy to talk to you. Bye for now.